Hey guys, my name is Kashif and in this video I'm going to show you some simple Google Play Store tricks and features which you might not have bumped into yet. It's possible you may be aware of some of all the Google Play Store tricks which I will mention, but a recap would be perfect for refreshing your memory. So here are the most helpful tips and tricks for the Google Play Store. Did you know that you can get refunds for paid apps in Play Store? Google is pretty lenient regarding what you can refund and reason for claiming a refund, and the process is fast and straightforward. And yes, you can return an app if you later decided you didn't want it. Learn more in the official website of the Google Play Store. I'll give the link in the description. Once you have purchased an app, on its Google Play Store page, you will see option to install or open. In addition, a refund option should appear on the left hand side. Tap the refund button within 2 hours of the purchase to get your money back and no question asked. For paid apps and games, you have 2 hours after your purchase to request a refund, or 48 hours if you make your refund request on web instead of through the Google Play Store app. The only exception is for unauthorized purchase, which have a limit of 65 days. The Play Store offers 3 distinct ways to lock down app installation, which comes in real handy if you regularly let your kids play games or stream videos on your device. Number 1 is fingerprint block. If your device has a fingerprint scanner, you can restrict the purchases to your fingerprint by going to settings, then user control, and then fingerprint authentication. Number 2 is parental control pin. You can also restrict purchases by going to settings, user control, then parental control and turn it on and set a pin, and you are good to go. And third one is mature content filter. You can set when the pin is necessary by going to settings, user controls, parental controls and set content restriction. You can now easily find out the lost Android mobile with the help of device manager. Go to the Google device manager and log in with your Google ID, and with this amazing feature you can find out your lost device. If you are really keen to get an app that's not available in your country, then you can still get your hands on by using a VPN. VPN means virtual private network, and it gives you secure internet connection via private networks in location outside of your current one. Basically, a VPN service can make it look like you are accessing the internet from a different location, and it's important that you choose a credible VPN. Once you have downloaded a VPN, select the country whose Google Play Store you want to access in the VPN app and get the VPN up and running. Then open the Play Store app. It should land on Google Play Store homepage of that country that you selected. Now you can get the app that you want to download. Sometimes you'll hear of an upcoming app that is generating a lot of buzz but hasn't been released of public yet. You can check if it's available as an early access app. And if it is, you may be able to try it out ahead of time. Be aware that early access apps are often buggy, glitchy, poorly optimized, and prone to crashes. The Google Play Store also allows developers to offer separate beta version of already released apps. These beta apps often have more features and other improvements but may not be quite ready for public release due to crashes, bugs, and glitches. So that's pretty much it guys for this one. If you like this content, make sure to press the like button and share this video with your friends. Subscribe for more content like these. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.